Electric force and magnetic force are acting on the charged particles. In this practice, we'd like to consider a magnetic force acting on a charged particle, and we'd like to find out the motions of the charged particles under a magnetic field. Magnetic force, called the Lorentz force, has expressions. Lorentz force. F, Q is a charge, V is a velocity of a charged particle, cross B. So this cross is a cross product. Or sometimes we could say the vector product. So quickly review the vector product. Vector product is a product of the two vectors. So if you consider the two vectors of the A vectors and the B vectors. So by these two vectors, we could determine the planes. Any point on the plane, you can express the sum of the two vectors, A and B. Vector product is defined as vectors perpendiculars on these planes. So this is perpendicular of the planes A and B vectors. So we could have two choices. One of the vector is upward, and the other one is downward. So this can be determined by the choice of the vectors A first or B first. So if you consider the A cross B, A cross B vectors, you can rotate your right hand following the A and the B. Then you can use that this is A vectors and B vectors. Actually, B vectors is exactly the this one. And if you rotate your right hand following the this weights, then actually the thumb point to the upward directions A and B. So this directions vectors becomes A cross B. And if you choose a B cross A, then your sum is pointed in this direction, B cross A. B cross A. This way, B cross A. So this direction, vector is B cross A. So vector product is defined this way. There is only two choice of the vector product. If you consider two vectors create planes, and the vector product is a perpendicular to this formed planes. And then to discover the direction, you should use your right hand. Okay, we call it right hand rule. And the magnitude, A cross B and B cross A exactly the same. Magnitude is expressed A vector, magnitude of A and the magnitude of B times sine theta. Theta is the angle between A and B vectors. So if you consider A vectors and B vectors, this is the angle of the theta. Okay, this is the definition of the vector product. The Lorentz force, actually this vector product we use, defined Lorentz force. So actually the charged particles, if the magnetic field is directed to the board, and then charged particle is moving upward, this B, what kind of the direction Lorentz force is acting, you should use a Q B cross B. So now we consider Q is a positive charge, then you can use a right hand, and then this is the direction of the Lorentz force of F. So this Lorentz force is acting on this charged particle. So motion of the direction of the discharged particle is actually the changing, moving the this weight, and then this is the velocity. Then again, you have to use this expression of the Lorentz force to discover the directions. So this is the direction of the F. And this particle is moving this way. And this is the velocity of B. And the Lorentz force you can consider, discover this is the direction. And then moving this way. And the particle has a direction, velocity of this way. And you could find that Lorentz force acting on this charged particles. Actually, this charged particle returns to the original point. So we could easily find that the circular motions. This is the orbit of the charged particles moving under a magnetic field. So now we'd like to come back to these questions. So we discovered orbit of the charged particles under the magnetic field is this is the magnetic field of B. Then velocity, charged particle is moving with a B. Then radius of the circular orbit is R. And the Lorentz force acting on this charged part. So Lorentz force is QB cross B. So if you want to find the magnitude of the Lorentz force, QBB sine angle between the velocity and the magnetic field is 90 degree. Sine 90 degree is 1. So it becomes QBB. B. Lorentz force is QBB. Then we'd like to write an equation of motions. This is MA equal F. In the circular motion, acceleration is expressed as V square over R. Lorentz force is a QBB. And then rotational frequency is omega, is related with the velocity, R omega. This is the angular frequency. And if you substitute this one, actually the one of the B is going to be cancelled out. So you have M omega equal QB. So omega is expressed QB over M. So this is actually important point is the angular frequency is independent. Of
R, independent. So independent of the R, even if you consider really small circles or large circles or really big ones, angular frequency is same. So if the three particles is static from the same position and then it's return to the original position at the actually exactly same times, because the angular frequency exactly same. And cyclotron frequencies. Frequency f is defined omega over 2 pi, and if you substitute omega is into this equation, you can find the cyclotron frequency 1 over 2 pi qb over n. This is the answer to these questions.